What's up guys, Electro here, and welcome back to Construction Sim 2015. If you didn't see the last episode, then you can see in the background, that's what we've bought. Yes, we bought a tower crane, and what that basically means is we can now do some large crane jobs, and we can start doing some form of concrete mixing jobs as well. So, I'm going to jump straight into the job market, and you can see our wealth is going to increase fairly dramatically because we can start doing some concrete work and we can start doing some proper good crane work as well. So we've done the tower crane tutorial in the last mission, so I'm going to simply jump back into a job, and it will be this one here. So a modern family house with a balcony, or modern house with a balcony. So we need a portable toilet, we need a generator, or generate a trailer from the materials trader. And those are two new things we haven't got just yet. Then we need to drive to a buildings material dealer. Okay, we need to get some large bricks, we need to get some asphalt, we need some concrete bags, pour the concrete into prepared elements on the construction site. Then we need some wall primer, some more pouring, some turf from the nursery, some yew tree seedlings, and some strawberry seedlings. So let's jump in and do that one straight away. So we need a portable toilet. Well, probably only one vehicle that we can use in order to do that, and that's this one here. So without further ado, I will catch up with you at the materials trader. See you guys in the team. Okay guys, welcome back. We're at the materials trader, so we're just going to jump out and grab the stuff that we need. Just refresh our memory as to what we do need here. We need to get a portable toilet and the generator. Cool. So it's the first time we've grabbed these. It will probably be under equipment. Yes it is. Generator and portable toilet. Both of those, and where are they? Okay, they didn't appear over here. Ah, here we go. Oh, one's on a trailer. Where's the toilet? Ah, and the other one's there, look, so we can. I would suggest, I think we've got a tow hitch. Looks like we have. I suggest we can reverse this one on. Yes, we can. Good. We probably need to raise the outrigger. Oh. There we go. Lights are all working, that's good. Always a good thing. So yeah, last time we had to pick the generator up, didn't we? This time it's totally different. Dropped their the crane outriggers out, and then we'll just pick the toilet up. There we go. Actually, bearing in mind we've got a trailer, probably not going to be too difficult to not too difficult to grab more stuff, I think. Let's go and have a look and see what else we can get on the next stage. And the game's frozen. Oh, we're back again. Okay. So we can get large bricks, asphalt, concrete bags. Yeah, we're probably not going to fit all that on, so we will just... Oh, I didn't know we could do that. Wow. Something clearly is going wrong there. Okay, we've got an issue there. I can't, for some reason, get into the lorry and use it properly. I'm going to have to try and reset that vehicle. If I'm honest, I don't really know. Why it's doing what it's doing. Ah, there we go. Don't really know what was going on there, guys. Bit of a bug, if I'm honest. We seemed to freeze and then had to reset the vehicle. That reset the crane. And, yeah, don't really understand what happened. Okay, so we're going to go back to the construction site, and as always, rather than bore you with the journey, I will catch up with you guys once we're there. Okay guys, so we're just about to arrive at the construction site, which is just here next to, right next to the vehicle dealership actually, and we've gone wrong straight away, haven't we? Jackknife that trailer into the picket fence there, lovely. Yeah, we needed to go down here. There we go, there's our warning signs and stuff. So, we can drop the trailer and that here. Need to drop that jockey wheel down on the trailer and then we will be able to disconnect. There we go. Hopefully we can spin this round and drop the portaloo somewhere next to it. Yeah, we should be able to get that in there. Down with our outriggers. So you guys have probably noticed I haven't been online too much recently, and there's been about a week or so, and there is a reason for that, and that's purely down to the upgrade in Windows that I've done. I've gone to Windows 10 from Windows 7, and if I'm honest, there were a few issues. It seems to have sorted itself out with a few updates recently, but I was having some major lag issues with certain games, and unfortunately this was one. It was don't really know what the problem was, but there were some real big issues in terms of the way I record games and things like that. I use Shadowplay to record, which is an Nvidia thing. Wow, that just kicked us straight off of there. Let me just go back to the building materials trailer. Yeah, I'll use Shadowplay to record. And I know not everyone will like it because you can't get separate audio channels and stuff like that for gameplay. I actually quite like it because you can use Shadowplay to record gameplay and you can use something else to record audio, like commentary, like I'm doing now. So I'll probably do a video on that at some point in the future, but ultimately what I do is sorry about that, guys, as my email was going off in the background and I don't really know how to disable it on Windows 10 at the moment, so I'll look into that and hopefully that will stop the annoying alerts going off every hour or so. So yeah, I've been using Windows 10 and there are a few lag issues recently. One of those I think was due to Windows 10. There's been an update recently which I've downloaded and it seems to have sorted stuff out. Fingers crossed, touch wood. And it was having a real sort of major impact on the way I record videos. So as I was saying, I use Shadowplay, which is an NVIDIA software, hardware system, if you can call it that, that basically records directly from the video card. And what that basically does is it means that the overhead or the resources it uses on your system are practically nil. Okay, so we're back at the materials trader and we need to grab a couple of large bricks, one asphalt and one concrete bag. That will do for the next part of this mission. Hopefully we won't get any more freezes like we have been. Do that, or we use the forklift, I think. It's easier, isn't it? That way we won't get any bloody freezes. For some reason I've inadvertently bought more bricks. Just, although you guys won't notice it, we had a little break between filming, so I've gone and bought all of that over again, which is great. Not too much of an issue, I imagine we'll use it at some point in the future. So as I was saying before about, I've had a few issues in the last week or so in relation to filming. I use Shadowplay to film game videos and I know some people don't really like Shadowplay because you can't have two separate audio channels. So basically you can record the game audio and that's pretty much it. You can push the talk button on Shadowplay or on your keyboard that works through Shadowplay that then records commentary, but at the point of edit it basically just combines those two channels, as it were, into one. You can have it so that Shadowplay runs the commentary alongside, so you don't have to press that button, so it's always on. It doesn't necessarily work very well. I used to do that and then I kind of worked out that if you needed to edit audio in any way, shape or form, that it kind of was hard to do really. So what I do now is I record my video with Shadowplay
and my audio I run alongside with Audacity, which is good because that means I can do other things with it, such as noise removal and other bits and bobs, and it works for me. So the whole reason I use Shadowplay is because of the file sizes. I know that some people that use other systems, like forgive me if I'm pronouncing this wrong, but DX3, something like that, they end up with absolutely massive files because they're recorded in AVI, whereas Shadowplay doesn't do that. It's recording in MP4 format. Be careful this one, because I think that, yeah, it is. Concrete bag sticking out ever so slightly. Yeah, it records in MP4 format, which basically means that I don't have massive files. They're big enough, but they're not insanely big. Right, well, we'll continue this back out the construction site, so I'll catch up with you guys once we've arrived there. So, welcome back, guys. We're just about to arrive at the construction site. So, yeah, as I was saying, I use Shadowplay, and the whole reason I do that is basically down to file size. The quality doesn't seem to differ in any way, shape, or form if we use Shadowplay compared to something like DX Tori, whatever it's called. And I've kind of done comparisons in relation to that. So, yes, the file sizes are huge on other systems, which are predominantly software based, whereas Shadowplay isn't, it's more hardware based. And I don't know, I'll just get on with it better, I think. The downside of gameplay and the editing software that I use is that it doesn't really get on very well with variable frame rates. Now, unfortunately, anywhere in gaming you're going to be getting variable frame rates, and that's just a fact of recording gameplay. Games tend to be of a variable frame rate. Well, they will be, because as you can tell, when you have a little frame rate thing in the corner of the screen, which you can get with Shadowplay, you can get with most other games, or most other game recording software, you'll see what your current frame rate is in the game. And yeah, because of that, it's obviously going to record that as a variable frame rate in the file. So when you come to edit, sometimes you can have an issue. Now, I haven't had an issue for quite some time, since I started this channel, basically the beginning of this year, 2015 now, and yeah, I haven't really had an issue at all up until now. Upgraded to Windows 10, and I was getting major desync issues in the software that I use to edit, and that was basically all down to frame rate. And what that basically means is that the software is just not 100% capable of dealing with a variable frame rate. There's probably only one software developer that's out there that deals with... Wait, there we go. That deals with... deals with sort of variable frame rates very well, and that's Sony. And Sony Vegas. They deal with it quite well, and you can use some of their sort of prosumer tools, as it were, like Vegas Pro 2, okay, where's that going? Turn around for the other. Come on, turn around, you bloody thing. Yeah, so Vegas Pro does it quite well. I don't have, well, I have an older version of it, but basically it's not capable of, it's not capable of recording at 1080p, so I know we don't record most of our videos at 60fps. Now, I do record them in-game at that, however, my software, you know, at the moment, and some of you will probably laugh at this because it's not really what a lot of other gamers will use, but I use Camtasia, or Cam Studio, I don't know what it's called. Not the cheap free version, but the paid version, and I kind of use that for online courses and stuff like that, so that's why I use it, and I've figured out you can use it for this. I'm not really too fussed about whether or not we use it for where the hell am I going to put this crane? I'm not going to be able to, am I? Yeah, we use it for I'm not really too fussed about using it for frame rate issues, so like in order just to get 60fps, I'm not really that bothered. There are some games I will do it for. This one I don't really think you need to run at 60fps. It's kind of smooth enough as it is, really. I know there's the occasional jolt, but it seems to do okay. Right, we need to pour some concrete, and the game's allowed us to do this because we've got that large tower crane. The problem I've now got is I can't put that tower crane anywhere. So I'm going to have to go and buy a concrete mixer, aren't I? Without trying to get run over. So let's go over to the vehicle dealer. He's only over the road. And I will catch up with you when we're there. Okay, guys, so we're at the vehicle dealer. We are going to have to buy one of the trucks that deals with this. So this one, 130,000. Yeah, we've got enough. What else do we have left to do? So we've got concrete, wall primers, concrete, turf, U seedling. Oh, okay. So there's a lot of concrete doing. We've now got a concrete mixer. It looks like we're probably going to have to go and do something in terms of a tutorial with it. Let's have a quick look and see what we've got here. We'll get in and out as usual. Okay. Oh, that just turns our help on and off, doesn't it? Not sure what that does. I think it might turn. Oh no, it's just the steering, isn't it? Yeah. X. This is turning. Oh yeah, we can press B. That's another MAN truck. Don't need that one anymore. Let's go to the tutorial and run through the concrete mixer one. Oh, we can't do that just yet. Okay. So what we'll do, we'll go and go back to the construction site, then we'll pour our first lot of concrete. We'll complete this section of the mission, and then we'll probably just come back and do the tutorial just so that we know exactly what we're doing. Because this is another new machine we've got. I wasn't expecting to have to buy this one halfway through a mission, which isn't great because that means we can't then do the tutorial straight away. Not too much of an issue because we can just go straight back to the construction site and basically delve straight in, can't we? Now I'm assuming we haven't actually got any concrete on board, so we can't pour. We'll go and try. But I'm assuming, yeah, we're going to have to go to... Okay, so we're just about to arrive at the gravel plant. We will jump in, and I'm pretty sure we have to go under the what looks like a concrete sort of mixing place. So. Which will be this one over here, I think. Yeah, so there's a sign there, and I remember seeing that before. Ah, there we go. That's filling up nicely. Now we can see it down the bottom in the progress bar. It's 30 odd percent at the minute. We're turning round nicely. Got to do to keep the concrete moving and not setting. Awesome, there we go. Wow, 5 grand. Okay, back to the construction site we go. Now, I'm assuming we're not going to use all of that. Well, I don't know. I'm only assuming we are. You know what everybody says about assume. We'll find out. We've got to pour that into the footings, so we'll see how quickly that fills up. Now I'm wondering, because the crane pours concrete, how the hell you use it to fill up? And why we got concrete bags last time round. Bit strange. Yeah, maybe the concrete bags were just to do the like the drywall elements and stuff that we did previously. There's tire marks on the road from when I went off-roading through that cornfield on the way. World's best driver. You don't stop at lights either, because nothing appears to happen if you go through them, so that's good. You don't get fined or anything. Not like Euro trucks in. Which, by the way, we'll be doing a few more videos on soon. I know that we've neglected it for the last couple of months, which isn't great. Right. Please tell me this is going to work. No. Why isn't that working? Do I need to be in a particular point? Okay. I have absolutely no idea what we're supposed to do. Maybe it's this front part because that's quite big. Please work, come on. little bit stumped. Don't really know what we're supposed to do. Pour concrete into the prepared elements at the concrete at the site. Do you know what I think? That we are supposed to pour them into there. And that isn't going to happen without that crane. So how, where the hell do I put the crane? I can't, can I? There is no marked area. No, there is not. There's absolutely nowhere. I've got to go and buy a crane, I think. And it's got to be the portable one, isn't it? Oh dear. Wow, we're absolutely rinsing money this time around. Let's go and see how much that is. We could get the concrete pump or the mobile crane. Oh God, one's 200. Oh, we're gonna have to go with this one. Now we're gonna have two tutorials to do. I wasn't expecting to have to buy both of these. Yes. We'll just jump straight back to the construction site for this one. Okay, so we're just about to arrive. So from what I remember seeing, we need to sort of unfold this one first. So this is completely out of the blue. Probably need to put these out yet. I imagine, yeah, this sort of folds out. Wow, this is a big, big pump. Look at the size of this, this is massive. Getting the mouse out of the way. Right, and then I think what we need to do is go and pour this. Into the back here. So we need to do some careful reversing. and I can't quite see, but I don't know if that's working or not. Appears to be. Right, yeah, that's now full. So I can go and turn this one off. We may have to leave that one on, I don't know. Ah, that's better. So, right, I'm assuming. Oh, bollocks. We'll wait for that to stop swinging. Wow, this is hard. Well, I think we're almost out of concrete. Yes, we are. Crap. Okay. Let's get that filled up again. Okay, it looks like I need to probably be in the bloody machine in order for it to fill up. So that keeps going, does it? It looks like it does. Yep, that's still going.
There we go. Right, now we can clear this. Components need to be retracted. Yeah, I know we do. I just don't know how we do that. But we've got to do it away from this thing. Well, this is a beast of a machine, isn't it? Absolute beast. I do hope not wasting that concrete. Turn the other one off and move that out of the way. Now we've got loads of traffic. Absolutely loads, so that can just be parked somewhere out of the way. Wow, this one's going to have a lot of parts to do in it, isn't it? A lot. Those legs, they're absolutely amazing. A beast of a machine. There we go. So we can leave this one over here because we're going to need to do something with that in a bit. They can stay there. So now we need wall primer. We need some wall primers and that was it, wasn't it? So let's go and do that. In the meantime, I'm hoping now I can set off. No, I can't. Don't know why I couldn't do that. I'm going to cancel that contract and get them going on another one because they're not earning us any money at the moment. And I don't want that to happen, so they clearly need to be earning us some form of cash. Wow, why is that not letting us do anything? Okay, that's that one as well. They can't do anything for the moment. I'll tell you what they can do, they can go and get us our wall primer. Can they? No. I don't know why that's not working. They're both free. That we bought the other day. Wall primer, so construction materials trader. So you can see our friendly chap over here, and we need two of them. Just block the entrance, it doesn't really matter. Okay, we'll jump in and pick up our wall primers.
which is like paint, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Oh, crap. Easy does it. Oh, crap. They're on. That's all we need. Okay, back to the construction site we go with our upturned paint. So as always, guys, yeah, I'll catch up with you once we're back. Okay, so we just arrived. We need to put them in. Put the old sides down. And unlatch them. One. Okay, we'll just clear the construction site. Hopefully we'll get a view of something changing if it does. And I'll just reverse out so that we can see the transformation happen before our eyes. There we go. So we've got more concrete to do, and then I think we've got some saplings and stuff to do, haven't we? So yeah, it looks like we have. Excellent. Well, we shall crack on with those last few bits and get this modern house with a balcony finished.
Okay, so what do we now need to do? We've got some more concrete pouring to do. So we're going to be pouring into the elements. To be fair, we probably could leave that there. So we'll extend our legs out. And we get to use this beast of a machine again. Unfold her. Just so that we can get access to the rear. This thing's so big, it barely fits it in the frame when you're unfolding, doesn't it? Let that swing down. Should do it for now, and then we can reverse the other truck up to, we've still got loads left in this. Let's reverse the other truck up to the mixer, or up to the pump at least. See what we're doing. It needs to be a little bit closer than that, doesn't it? A little bit closer. Here we go. Should now be working. It appears to be. Let's have a look and see if. Yeah, there we go. Right, we need to release that again because that slips back down. Oh. I mean, there was a way to stabilize this thing. All right, there we go. Let's fill that part up. Going for this little bit. Should fill up that and another part of the wall, yeah. And there we go, let's gonna do that little small bit there. Tiny little bit left over here that we need to do. we'll just make sure that's filled right up. There we go. And we can fold this beast of a machine away, this crazy machine. It is pretty epic, isn't it? There we go. Okay, so now we've got to do concrete pouring into the prepared elements on this one. I'm not quite sure where we're going to have to pour. Didn't need to fold it all the way either, all the way back either, did we? Think about purchasing a new vehicle. I think we've done that enough in this episode, don't you guys think that? Yes, we're not going to be doing anything more in relation to that just at this stage. Alright, I'm assuming we just go ahead and pour. Oh, stop it. Just to almost make a flat roof by the looks of it. By the looks of it, that's what we need to do. Isn't really. Oh, there we go. Didn't think it was doing it properly then. Creating a lovely flat roof here. Come on. There we go. Right. So now it's just a bit of landscaping to do by the looks of it. There we go. There's that flat roof we've just poured, nice and concreted. Building's still not finished yet because it's got no windows or anything like that, but. Should just fold this away. Quite a while to do so. It is such an awesome machine, look at it. Pretty epic. Oh. Anyway, we need to go and sort the other pump out first. 82% of the concrete that we've had left in this one. We're not going to need any more concrete at the moment, so I'm going to take this one back to our home base at the city.
Then I'm going to jump back into our concrete pump. Finish folding that away. We seem to have this little whacker plate thing here, don't we, that we don't seem to own, but it's always at the building site. There we go, and we'll take this one back to the home base as well. So we're really racking up ownership now of vehicles, aren't we? We've got our concrete mixer there, look. Still turning because we've got concrete in it. We've got the little tipper. We've got the roller. We've got the mini excavator and a trailer. We've got our skip lorry. And now we've got this beast, the concrete pump. We've got, still got the crane, which is pretty awesome. We should be able to pump concrete with this, but if I'm honest, I don't quite know how at the moment. Look at that shadow animation as well, that's pretty cool, isn't it? Always a good day here in this city. Always sunny. No rain. Just turn that round for a bit more effect. So tall you can't even see the end, look. Okay, stop messing around, and we need to go back to our flatbed truck with a crane, which is across the road from our construction site, and then we are going to, we need to get some turf, yew seedlings and snowberry seedlings. So turf at the nursery, all three at the nursery, that's not too much of an issue. Have we got any other active jobs? No, we haven't, it's just the one. Let's see what we can get our crew going on. Gives us 32,000, let's accept that. And we'll get our guys working on that one as we finish off this one. Jobs, active. Yes. Right, so we need to go to the nursery. I'm just going to jump there, I think. Nursery, we've only got the one that's in the village, yep. Okay. 180 credits to get us here, but it's not too much of an issue. We're going to see our friendly nursery dealership owner, Green Thumb. Okay, we need one of them, and we need some turf. Two turf, there we go. Awesome. Drop that. I'm going to get into our, into this little beast, and we're going to pick up. Let's go for our turf first because we've got two of them. So yeah, next episode we will probably do a smaller mission, I think, and I didn't pick it up. Yeah, a smaller mission, and we'll do the two tutorials just so that we've covered absolutely everything. Whoa! I have absolutely no idea what happened there. So there are some bugs in this game. That was one of them. I'm not entirely sure what. What we can do with that, because that's just gone flying. Let's see if we can pick it up. I'll have to move these cars out of the way. If not, because that's kind of gone through the ground, hasn't it? There we go, it's kind of got it. Kind of got it out of the ground. Really don't know what happened there. A little bit of a bug, perhaps. We'll just stick this on the trailer. So still lots to come in this let's play, guys. Whoa, this thing is all over the place. This forklift is messed up. Yeah, so lots still to come in this let's play, guys. We've got still a fair few amount of vehicles to get through. We've got both of the DLCs to get through still. Haven't got them yet. What I'm talking about, the concrete pump being a bit of a beast. Well, we haven't seen the pile driver or the drilling rig yet, have we? So yeah, they're going to be pretty epic. Pretty epic they're going to be, I reckon. What else have we got? I think we've got most of the low boy, and we've got the larger excavator, the loading shovel. Yeah, there's a lot to do. And what, we're on episode 13, I think. There's still a fair amount to go. It's probably going to take us a fair few series, I think, to get through everything. And that's without even touching on the community sort of stuff. So some people have released some different missions where you have to build a skyscraper with tons and tons and tons of parts. So we'll be looking at those in the future. This game probably is not going to go away for a little while. So if you like Construction Sim 2015, then don't remember to hit that. Don't forget. Do remember to hit that subscribe button so you know when the next episode's coming. Oh, we're going to lose that one. And there's one of the problems with this game, is that things glitch. Glitching through the bloody forks, even though I picked it up properly. Get rid of the mouse out of the way. So there's going to be a lot of gameplay still to come in this. I probably haven't been uploading as frequently as I want to, partly due to my work schedule. I'm going to try and change that so we do at least one episode a day, just so that we can get through things a little bit quicker. Bugger. Only because I think this game is pretty epic, pretty awesome. I know there's been a ton of Let's Plays, but people generally don't finish their Let's Plays. I want to try and do as much as we can on this game as possible. But we have to start somewhere, and this is somewhere. Right, back to the construction site. Let's just double check we're going to the right one. Let's have a look on the old map. No, because that's the one in the village. And our construction site is in Uptown. So we just want to go out of the nursery and down the road here. And as always, guys, I'm not going to bore you with the journey. So we're going to go via the gravel pit back to the city, where I'll catch up with you guys once we're back at the construction site. So see you in a tick. Okay, so we're just about to arrive back at our construction site with the final parts of this build. We shall crane them off into the marked area and then evacuate and watch the build miraculously happen in front of our eyes. Okay, let's unstrap and let's start craning. Let's crane! As our workers just finished something else, probably it's their last step. Yeah, so we can get them going on that. Okay, let's unload. Last couple of bits and then I think we'll be done. It's probably going to tip us over onto, hopefully XP wise, onto level 10. Let's have a look. There we go. So we can clear the construction site now. Turn this round. Put the sides back up on the truck. Lift up our outriggers and then we're done. We could probably reverse back out. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, we'll reverse back out and then we can see it. So, somehow that didn't give us any XP, and I don't really understand why. Oh, hang on. No, that was the workers that have done that. So, we're going to watch ours going imminently. There we go. 7688, so yeah, it should tip us over into level 10, hopefully. and that's given us 192,000. Wow, look at that house. Right, let's just park up here and go and inspect our work. I didn't flip over to number 10. I don't understand why not. Gives a fair amount of XP, but hasn't sent us over the edge. So we're just going to go and do a bit of trespassing. For some reason we can't. There's some sort of invisible barrier there, which means we can't go and have a look. But what have we got? We've got a house, some sort of small pond. Wow, that's good, isn't it? Little wood store there, look. Little playground area, little shed. And the house itself. Wow. Yeah, that was a good build. Interesting one, because it was the first one we had to do with our concrete pump. So, let's jump back to our home base. And we'll just have a quick chat about what we've achieved this episode. So, we got two new vehicles, which was the concrete pump here. And we got the concrete mixer, which is just over here. So, guys, as always, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Construction Sim 2015. Let's get rid of the mouse. I'm going to try and do an episode a day. I can't promise it, but they're going to become hopefully a little bit more frequent than they are at the moment. So, if you want to know when the next episode is coming out, you can get email alerts, etc. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, give us a thumbs up or comment below, and I'll see you next time on episode 14 of Construction Sim 2015. Take care, guys. Bye for now.